The two chapters number 53a and 153b of the Book of the Dead talk about the spells needed to escape from the net and protect the dead from falling into the net of the birds, catchers, and the nets of the fishermen. There are many magical texts that talk about hunting and catching people in the nets, and they are texts that accompany the scenes of the rituals and told during the performance of these rituals. It's essential to tell the name of the enemy if the matter concerns a certain enemy, and not in general for jinx and pessimism, and thus to accomplish the defined purpose of destroying and eliminating that enemy. Mentioning the name of the enemy is a part of the practical rituals that were practiced to destroy Set and Abophis and the dangerous dead. The name plays an important part in the frame of the Egyptian magic, for the name indulges and is mixed totally with the entity of its owner, and can replace him, whether he's a god or a human. The practice of magic was based to a great deal on using the name, so knowing the name is a first requirement in many practices that happens against someone. It's noticeable that destroying and damaging the name is a certain destroy in the future for the owner of that name, and that's what had happened during Amarna period in destroying and smashing and removing Amun's name off the walls of his temples by Akhenaton and his followers, and the followers of the creed of his god Aton. Likewise, the followers of Amun later destroyed the name of Akhenaton and the creed of Aton after Amarna period was over, for it was considered against the Egyptian traditional creed throughout its ages. So they agreed to erase all what represented it and annihilate it completely, so that he or his creed isn't immortalized through the preservation of the name.
Doesn't this